All right, what's up, guys? I hope you're enjoying the weekend. We've got a big, big study day ahead. On Friday, I posted this video lesson of Stephen Ducks, who's my challenge student, who made nearly $100,000 last week. He's closing in on $1 million, even as he's in school and focusing on a double major. So this guy is a workaholic, and he made a nice video lesson showing you some patterns that are working. So please study that. But today's topic is this guy, Tim Gertani, because I just wrote a blog post on timothysykes.com talking about 40 lessons from Tim Gertani passing $4 million in profits. That's right, the man, the myth, the legend, my top trading challenge student who's also become a great, you know, trading challenge teacher. Your trading challenge students should take advantage of his nearly 50 live webinars that he's given exclusively to trading challenge students. He's already given 4 live ones in 2017 already. 4 seems to be his magic number. You know, he's given 4 live webinars in 2017. This blog post that I wrote on timothysykes.com that you need to check out, 40 lessons, because he passed 4 million in profits. And he's also made 402,000, I think, or 405,000 in 2017 already. You can see all of his trades transparently. Hold on, let's see. I think it was, he's up 4.02 million now. But here are his trades. Pretty freaking remarkable. Let's see his year to date. I think it was 402. Oh, 407,000 in just the first 2 months of the year. So please check out this blog post on timothysykes.com. And if you, you know, really appreciate him, and you all should, frankly, please go to the bottom of this blog post and leave a comment and just congratulate him, you know, thank him on, you know, just being so transparent and helpful. I know how many of you guys are in the trading challenge chat room asking him questions. Lay off him a little bit, please. You know, have him just live, let him live his life a little bit. I know he wants to help, and, you know, he's too nice to say this like Stephen Ducks, but I'm gonna come in because I see you guys like asking him so many questions. If you want to learn from Tim Gertani, you know, he has a DVD called Trading Kickers. And I mean, some of the reviews, I mean, best DVD I've ever seen, you know, extraordinary, start this as your trading education, epic. It's the number one rated guide on investimonials with over 100 reviews. And there's over 36 live trades in his DVD. So start there if you want to learn from him. And he has slightly different rules than me, as you'll learn. There's not one magic formula for making millions. But he has actually made 2.5 times what I made in my first 5 years. He joined my trading challenge in August of 2012, so roughly 4.5 years. And he's just become an amazing trader, an amazing teacher, and he's just an amazing guy too. He's really humble. He's very low-key. If you read this blog post, you'll see, you know, he likes t-shirts and cargo shorts and gym shorts. I got to give him crap about that. We made him dress up when I took him to the Maldives. This was his first overseas trip, and this was when he just had passed like 100,000 in profits. But I knew there was something a little special about him, you know, his dedication and hard work, namely. And also, I have to mention, I have to thank the Cambodian government. You know, I don't know if you guys saw this. I just posted this on my Facebook page, but the Minister of Justice of Cambodia is pinning a medal on me here, and you know, all the Cambodian press is taking pictures. This is my school in the background, and I love, you know, meeting celebrities and you know, influential people and getting a medal and plaques. That's nice. But as I said in this Facebook post, I'm kind of a simple guy too, you know, and really just meeting all the kids, that was enough for me. If you guys ever get fortunate enough, you know, to really open your own school and do these kinds of amazing things, when you meet the kids and their parents and, you know, they're just crying tears of joy, education is the key. And once you start to realize that, it'll really change your life. But I do appreciate the Minister of Justice and, you know, the medal that he gave me and the plaque. It's pretty awesome. But right now I want to talk about Tim Gertani and the 40 lessons, because I want this to be a detailed video. You know, I know some of you guys learn better from reading, some of you learn better from videos. So I try and share it all just to maximize this opportunity. You know, Tim Gertani himself is not a big fan of milestones. You know, when he famously passed $1 million, he went out for pizza with his girlfriend at the time, who's now his wife. pretty hilarious that, you know, his milestones, they're nice. I mean, you do have to celebrate them, but at the same time, he understands that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, even 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 million. It's nice, but it's more about the journey. And a lot of you guys have to realize that it's not just about the money. You know, when you're going through this journey, you have to appreciate the ups and the downs. He hasn't always made money. So let's get to 40 lessons and let's go through it. I included a lot of links and videos and stuff like that. But number one, great success takes time. A lot of you guys want to make 4 million, 5 million more. But you have to understand, he is arguably the most successful trader in the world in the past 5 years, you know, who shows every single trade. There's people out there who claim to be millionaires and they show one or two screenshots. Show me every trade, okay? Show me how much you're risking up and down. You know, Tim Grittani and I don't use leverage, which kind of is astounding to many people in the trading industry because leverage has become so commonplace. But he also did not have success for the first 9 months. He was not consistently profitable. So you really need to have the proper perspective. But also don't be afraid to bet big on perfect setups. Now, this comes with a warning. You know, when you're just starting, you don't know what the perfect setups are. A lot of you guys are just beginning to learn what works best in the market, what works best for your personality and your schedule. We're all different. But once you learn, then you can start to bet bigger. And this is why Tim Grittani's biggest gains have come recently, because you get in a kind of a rhythm and on the right path. But it takes time to get there. But when you do get there, don't be afraid to bet big. Also, don't run and hide from your losses, okay? He's lost several times, pretty big. He did not run from them. He learned from them. He posted about them. And that's what you should use losses for. They're not something to be, you know, hidden away like some kind of leper. You know, talk about them, highlight them, learn from them. And, you know, that's how you get better. Too many of you guys have losses and you don't want to post it. You don't want to talk about it. You just want to forget that it ever happened. Losses are part of the journey for all of us. And to his credit, Tim Grittani has been controlling his losses much better lately. And also understand, he started with just $1,500 to his name 5 years ago. So it's okay to start small. And I think actually it's a good thing because it gives you time to really test, 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 refine, refine, refine. You know, you have to think of yourself as a scientist. So I have many students who start with like 100,000, 500,000, and they don't even become millionaires because they take their money for granted. They can't start small. You know, they can't justify even spending a lot of time on it. Like if you have $100,000 to your name, you want to start making 10, 20, 30, 40,000. You don't want to try and make 50 or 100 or 200 and start small. It's beneath you, as I've learned with a lot of these, you know, snobby rich students. So don't feel bad if you start small. I think it's actually a really good thing. Even if you do have 100,000 to your name, I would suggest starting with just 2 or 3,000 and really going through the process of learning how to build your account one trade at a time. Also, keep detailed notes and spreadsheets. Tim Grittani has a whole blog post on his spreadsheet building. Read this. This is number 5. This is a very important one. Number 6, never forget your roots and stay humble. And, you know, I've had many issues over the years with this lesson. Tim Grittani, to his credit, has not. You know, he's the same guy and he's so down to earth and it's freaking awesome. Number 7, don't be afraid to change brokers. So many of you are like, oh, I've been with this broker or, you know, I've been with this stock. You get married to certain positions and certain brokers. As a trader, you must always be willing to change and adapt. Okay, like you really need to embrace trading for all its glory. And you're always trying to change and optimize, optimize, optimize. Tim Grittani and I both have used a ton of different brokers. And that's always gonna be the case. You know, we try and use brokers and then we try and get better. Number 8, yes, you can short sell penny stocks. I still get emails to this day from people saying, you can't short sell penny stocks. This is illegal. My broker says no one's allowed to do that. Your broker sucks, okay? And your broker is a liar. Many brokers out there say you can't do it just so that you don't realize how bad they are when they don't have basic borrows. Shorting penny stocks is perfectly legal. You just need to find shares to short. This is a good one, number 9. He's been on fire, earning $400,000 in the first 2 months, but this is not a 9-to-5 type job. Sometimes you'll have good months, sometimes you'll have bad months. It's not like linear And a lot of people can't understand that. Like, they want to be paid by the hour. Sometimes you work and you trade and you research and you don't get paid for all your time. It doesn't matter how much research you put in. You cannot necessarily guarantee success on any one trade. So you have to be willing to understand that. But the goal is to focus on the big thing over time. This is why I post pictures of $1 million in cash in my Ferrari and Lamborghini. None of this stuff happens very quickly. And you need to go with the flow and go through the motions, go through the whole journey. You can't cheat. You can't just get ahead and say, oh, I'm an amazing trader. I'm going to make money every single month. Sometimes you will lose. It's okay. It helps mold you. Number 10, be committed to your goals. This is why I have, the millionaire challenge. This is why on my website it says, are you ready to be a millionaire? Some people will say, oh, you shouldn't focus on that. Just try to make $100 a day. Be realistic. If you actually look at studies of performance theory and goal setting, having a big goal helps improve your daily performance 15 to 25% because you're working hard on something that is going to take many years, that you know is going to take many years, versus a lot of these scalpers and a lot of these people who are just like, Tim, I just want to make money. I just need to pay rent next month. Just give me a hot stock pick. I don't want to learn. Wrong mentality, wrong mindset. If you're using stock trading profits to pay rent, you probably shouldn't be trading, okay? 90% of traders lose. So if all the traders are looking to pay their rent and to pay for food, 9 out of 10 people are going to be homeless and very hungry. So it's not a way to pay for basic necessities. You need to be committed to your long-term goals. This is why when we have sales on these newsletters, it's only on annual newsletters because you're not going to change your life and learn everything you need to know in a few days, weeks, or even a few months. I'm sorry that education takes time, but you need to see great plays. You need to witness them. You need to execute them. You need to be wrong sometimes and see how that feels. It's all a process. You cannot cheat to get ahead. Okay, I'm not just going to give you $4 million. It's not like winning the lotto. And if you actually look at a lot of the lotto winners, they're screwed up in life because they got their money too easily. They didn't earn it. Their whole mindset and self-worth is all off. Trust me, when you start making $1 million, $2 million, $3 million, $4 million, it's not just about the money. It's about the achievement and the journey that you took to get there. I know that sounds weird, but it's seriously what you learn. Number 11, Tim Grittani has had a hell of a run and you just have to get inspired by his journey. We made this video. This took a lot of editing. This took me like 3 months of editing. I edit my own videos too. I'm kind of a control freak. But just watch this video and check out his journey. And mind you, he was a success when he had taken 1500 and turned it into 100,000 plus when we went to the Maldives. Now, obviously he's doing much more things. Number 12, you don't need a big fancy office, okay? And this blog post, you'll see where he's trading from a coffee shop. And you don't need fancy clothes, and you don't need to be some classy snob. Look at him. Look at his basic stuff. He's a basic bitch, and I love it, okay? I usually look like this too, except at my trading conferences where, I have to put on a suit and dress shirts and look all nice. Tim Grittani, to his credit, even when he speaks at my annual conferences, he does not change his clothes. I think last year he actually did fulfill his promise of wearing gym shorts. and that's kind of the cool thing about trading. You don't need really anything. You just need an internet connection. Excuse me. It's tough to do charity all day and then trade and make videos all night, but I love it. So. Number 14, focus on your goals first and foremost. Even as he's, getting blown up basically in this viral blog post from CNN, he ignored the hype and he stuck with it. Number 15, ignore the financial media. They have no idea about penny stocks. All they know of is Wolf of Wall Street. Tim Grittani and I went on Fox multiple times to try to explain this. We brought these little cheap items here. Because I was like, you can either buy a stock trading at a dollar or this can of Diet Coke. And this, I don't even know her name, this host of Fox and Friends, she was like, so wait a minute. So you can buy penny stocks in Coca-Cola? And I'm like, no, it's just an analogy. Like, the media has no idea about penny stocks. And you just have to accept that. And most people out there in the world aren't going to understand it either. I know a lot of, you know, family and friends out there, they're like, don't learn this stuff. It's all a scam, Wolf of Wall Street. Ignore the ignorance out there and frankly, be grateful for it. If more people understood this game, then you would have more competition. But the good news is the vast majority of people out there ignore this niche. 99.9% of people who do trade penny stocks just believe in these companies and they invest in them like it's the lotto. So if you use strategy, if you're meticulous and you learn to bet against them or to even, you know, ride the hype up when the mob of idiots buys everything, you know, you have an advantage. Number 16, Tim Grittani believes in cutting losses intelligently versus me, and I believe in cutting losses quickly. There's no one right way, okay? I know that you want simple, clearly defined rules that work for everybody, but we're all different. And Tim Grittani is a far more aggressive trader than me. I think for beginners, cutting losses quickly is much more important, especially when you don't know what you're doing. I don't want you to risk blowing up and, you know, really losing your account, losing your confidence, and then having your friends and relatives be like, I told you, penny stock trading is a scam. I know that happens. If you follow my rule number one about cutting losses quickly, you will not have big losses. And you'll never have that opportunity for your friends and family to say, I told you so. Versus Tim Grittani, you know, sometimes he does have some bigger losses, but he also has bigger gains. So you have to do what's right for you. But for me, I'm going to teach safety first. Number 17, don't focus on your profits and losses on any one play. Focus on trading the setup and pattern well. You know, Tim Grittani doesn't even look at his profits and losses, which to me is sounds absolutely insane. You know, I'm always focused on what is my gain, what is my loss. I need to cut my loss. I need to know my risk and exposure. He is really a student of the charts and price action. And it's really fantastic watching him ignore that. You know, maybe because I'm greedy and I'm Jewish, or maybe just because I've been around for so long and I've seen so much crazy stuff, I have to look at my profit and losses. Again, you have a choice. Tim Grittani and I are both successful, but we have different rules. Number 18, milestones don't matter. I'm going to make a lot more to do about this than Tim Grittani will. You know, and I'd appreciate it if you guys, again, would leave a comment below this blog post. Just congratulate him, thank him for all his hard work, and help him understand how much this means to you. I understand because I get more emails and I talk with more traders than probably anybody else in the world. Milestones are a very good inspirer. You know, this is the kind of stuff like, oh my God, Tim Grittani made 4 million. You know, the CNN article when he turned 1500 into a million, that went viral. Milestones don't necessarily matter to the person who's making them, but they do matter to you guys. So use this. You know, it's no different than, you know, a famous basketball player making all these triple doubles like Russell Westbrook, or, you know, Steph Curry making all these threes, or, you know, different baseball players who don't take steroids hitting a lot of home runs. Milestones, it's human nature. So don't feel bad if you do care about milestones. And obviously we all have different milestones. Some of you guys, many of you guys would just like to make $10,000 or $100,000. So don't feel bad, but also understand that it's kind of crazy. All of my top millionaire students don't give a shit about milestones. They do give a shit about trading, but they understand that this is just a number. And it's not life-changing. Like, it doesn't matter if you're at 4.02 million or 3.99 million. You're rich either way. So understand that when Tim Grittani, I know, is going to probably just not be so excited about this milestone, but feel free to be excited because I'm freaking excited. This is amazing. My God. Ah, I want to scream. I'm pretty excited. It's kind of crazy. You know, when I first got into teaching, I said I was going to create a millionaire from scratch. People laughed. Then I created one and two. And now we have several and several upcoming ones. So for me, this is a game of just proving that this stuff is actually, you know, replicable. So milestones do matter for me, even if they don't matter for Tim Grittani as much. Number 19, I know some of these rules seem counterintuitive, but that's what it takes to be a successful trader. You know, I wish that trading were easier. Trust me. But a lot of the stuff that you have to do and that you have to learn, it's kind of like tying one arm behind your back and, you know, still learning how to operate. because, you know, you have to think differently, and it forces you to really think outside the box, and it hurts your brain and hurts my brain. You know, when obviously you want to lately, especially dip buy, or, you know, sometimes you want to buy a stock hitting new highs, like it's tough. You have to fight your gut instinct, and you have to train yourself. It's not about your gut instinct. It's about seeing what patterns and rules work and then adapting and doing them. But number 20, don't try to mimic Tim Grittani's success or my success or anyone else's success. Don't follow alerts from any of us. You have to carve out your own path in this. You know, feel free to be inspired and see what's possible. I mean, that's only, you know, human nature. But at the same time, understand that, you know, Tim Grittani was not trying to become the next Tim Sykes. And you shouldn't be looking to become the next Tim Grittani or Tim Sykes. And you don't have to be named Tim. You have to do what's best for you. And the cool thing about having students now in over 80 countries is that we have a very wide base of different people. And we're all in this for different reasons. Some of us just want to make an extra few hundred dollars. Some of us aren't even trading and we just want to learn. Some of us do want to become millionaires. You have to do what's right for you and feel free to adapt and change your goals. You know, if your first goal is just to make $10,000 and then you actually do, then up your goal. Be like, okay, I accomplished my first goal of making 10 grand. Now let me aim bigger and try to make 100 grand. Once you make 100 grand, maybe then you try to make a million. But if you have a $2,000 account, you can't just say, oh, I need to make $1 million right away. Take it one trade at a time, learn from our success, see what's working, but understand that you are different from everybody else. And what one pattern works for Tim Grittani might not work for you. Tim Grittani loves shorting morning spikes. I have never successfully been able to do that consistently. It just doesn't work with my personality. When I short morning spikes, they tend to keep going. And when I don't do it, that's when they're usually good. So that's not a pattern that I like doing. But Tim Grittani has worked on that and he's done well. Number 21. Remember that 90% of traders lose and you don't have to trade every day. I know that many of you guys with small accounts think like, oh, 4 million, I got to make $20 here, $50. Oh, this is going to take a while. As your account grows, you can take bigger positions and, you know, you can start to really learn, wait a minute, let me wait for these perfect plays and forget about the little small scalps of making $20 or $50. Even those, some of you guys with like $2,000 or $3,000 accounts, you can make $500 or $1,000 on one trade if you wait for the proper setups, especially supernovas. Also, number 22, I just included this webinar that we did with Tim Grittani when he passed 3 million. This is a must watch. Bookmark this video and memorize it. Number 23, he's a role model in trading, not just in trading, but in our community. So please, again, leave a comment below this post and just congratulate him and, you know, show him how many of you guys there are. I know a lot of you guys don't necessarily always comment, you know, you're just learning. Do me a favor and come out of the shadows and post a comment below this blog. It would mean a lot to me. I know it's a favor. You don't have to say anything huge. Just say like, congrats, Tim Grittani, or some of you Trading Challenge students who Grittani is mentoring. You know, just say thank you for your time. I want him to see how grateful and how big our community is because a lot of people don't realize it. It's kind of crazy how we have the most number of students, the most number of real students. And it's kind of awesome how big our community has grown. And I really want Tim Grittani to understand what's going on and how important he is to everybody and just help him feel a sense of community. I know many of you guys talk with him on the norm, on the regular, but just leave a comment below and just, you know, voice yourself. I want to see hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands of comments because I know you guys are watching these video lessons and all you have to do is scroll down to the bottom of the post and leave a comment. And, you know, I don't need like your full name. I don't need your social security number. Just asking you to show him how many people out there do care about him and his lessons and how grateful we all are. I'll leave a comment. I'm very grateful. 24, his DVD has over 36 live trades. And I think they really are hugely helpful. So I posted just one as an example where he made like a 20 grand profit. Number 25, understand that patterns repeat themselves. when he made $200,000 in a day, actually, it was kind of funny. I was in Japan. I guess I should come to Asia more often. He always has big days and big milestones when I'm in Asia. it was kind of funny. Mark Crook actually told me, you know, that he, you know, did well in one day. It's tough for me to be in the chat room all night long when I'm, you know, out doing my charity stuff now. Before, I was out exploring Asia. Now I'm out with my charity. Mark Crook messaged me when he made $200,000 in a day. And Crook was like, hey, Tim, Grittani just made 200. And I'm like, Crook, why are you even bothering me? You know, with who cares if he made $200? And I specifically remember this. I have to dig up this conversation. And Crook is like, no, not $200, $200,000. And I was actually filming a video. I think there's video of me, like my face going white, because this was, you know, many years ago before Tim Grittani, you know, was the success he is today. But making 200,000 in a day, like, I was just like, holy crap, like, this is a big occasion. But number 25, understand that patterns repeat themselves. And the same pattern that he made 200 grand on in a day was on FNMA. FNMA is doing the exact same kind of patterns these days too. Number 26, learn from his monthly recaps. Here are just a few of Tim Grittani's recaps. Don't get on him for being like, oh, you must post a recap every single month. Let the man live, okay? He's not beholden to you to post his recaps all the time. Be grateful for when he does. Tim Grittani is kind of like shares to short on a pump and dump. You know, you can't expect shares to short on a pump and dump. You can't expect Tim Grittani to just post everything all the time. Sometimes, you know, he was moving to the Caribbean. He got married. You know, sometimes his life gets in the way. So be grateful every time that, you know, he does share this stuff, because it's freaking awesome. Number 27, I said, you know, he's not beholden to anybody. I guess I already went into that. Number 28, get inspired by his biggest and best trades. You know, look through his trades and see what he did right. And then also look through his trades and see when he's had big losses. You know, he's been stubborn in the past before sometimes. And I remember on Lake, I mean, right here, when he lost 290,000, I mean, he started swinging for the fences, as he willingly admits. And, you know, we were texting back and forth, and he's like, I'm just going to keep betting big. It's make or break. I know this stock is crap. And eventually, Lake did come down, so he was right. But at the same time, he cut his losses. This could have been, I think, maybe a $500,000 or $600,000 loss if he didn't cut his losses. But to his credit, he's gotten a lot better. And that's number 30. You know, the worst mistake that you can make is not necessarily the big losses that you'll ever have, but giving up and cutting your education short. This is why I really say cut losses quickly, because I know how much pressure you guys are under to study and trade, not just with yourselves, but again, with your friends and family. Trust me, I hear it from everybody, okay? No one says, hey, you're getting into penny stock trading? Good for you. That's an amazing industry with full of, you know, hedge funds and Wall Street legends. That's a very good choice. No, nobody ever says that if you say you're getting into penny stock trading. Everybody thinks that you're getting scammed and you're going to lose everything. So when you have these big losses, it's very easy to give up and give in to, you know, what the general consensus is with penny stocks. We all have had big losses. And frankly, if you're in this game long enough, no matter how confident you are in any one play, you will have a big loss. And the big loss should not define you, and it should not be the end of your education. The biggest mistake that you can make is not the big loss itself, but letting any big loss cut your education short, okay? Tim Grittani, myself, we've had big losses, but we've come back, and we've learned from those losses. I had a $500,000 plus loss once upon a time, okay? And I was trading an illiquid penny stock. I broke my trading rules. Frankly, I didn't even have my trading rules crystallized at that point in time. But I stuck with it, and I made it all back and more. So regrouping and reviewing and getting better and molding over time, that is something that you should really be into. And number 31, I say to his credit, Tim Grittani has controlled his losses better lately. For me, I think that's a very important lesson, especially when you're just beginning. I don't want you to ever give up. I don't want you to put yourself in the position of potential disaster. And that's number 32. I'm just talking out loud and I'm going into the next lessons. I really, really like cutting losses quickly. You know, I don't want to let a small mistake turn into a potentially big disaster. So many times I'll cut losses quickly. I'll take profits too quickly, even when I don't have to. But it's just because I like trading like a coward. And I like teaching you guys to trade like a coward. You know, there's more than enough volatility in this niche. You do not need to bet big. You do not need to use leverage. Number 33, Tim Gertone has also experimented with posting his watch list in the past. Read this post to read it, to see how to read his watch list whenever he does share this information. And I got to get Gertone to use stocks to trade because I think that that'll really help make your life easier when you're looking to find the best stocks and, you know, to build a watch list. Number 34, I said, trying to detail 40 solid lessons is really tough, but anything truly worth doing in life isn't going to be easy, so you must give it 110%. I'm filming this and I wrote this in the middle of the night here, but I wanted to get this out on a weekend so that you have time to read it. I wanted it to be, you know, close to real time when Tim Gertone achieved it. He just passed this on Friday. And this is a good analogy for literally anything worth doing in life, okay? If everything were easy, if it was easy to become a millionaire, not everybody would want to do it because it would just be like, oh, it's just like, you know, drinking a Coca-Cola. It's so easy. You don't really appreciate it. So as my top millionaire students and I have learned, you know, again, the money is a nice reward, but it's all about the journey and the ups and the downs and the roller coaster and how well you ride it and how you learn to control it and just challenging yourself to see what you're capable of. That's why I call it the millionaire challenge. You know, it's not just about the money. The money is nice and it's a nice reward, but how much can you discipline yourself and control your emotions and psychology, and how much time can you put into mastering this skill? That's the question. Some of you guys message me, Tim, how little money can I put into an account? How quickly can I become a millionaire? Those are the wrong questions, okay? You need to understand how difficult this journey is going to be. And to my credit, I think that I have explained this quite a bit, that it's not an easy path. Number 35, to those who say I made all my money during the tech bubble and was lucky, my best trading year was actually in 2014, where I made nearly $1 million, and there was no bubble then. And similarly, Tim Gertone's success is not due to luck, it's due to hard work. But if you really want to say, look, we're just lucky, okay, fine, I give in. But the harder we work, the more we research, the luckier we get. That's the reality. Number 36, we do not use leverage of any kind, okay? These stocks are more volatile than you need them to be. And if you just focus on taking the meat of the move, that's more than enough. You do not need to use leverage. And frankly, I think that, especially in the beginning, until you really know yourself and get to know what you're good at, leverage can be very, very dangerous. Forget about just losing all your money. Imagine losing all your money and owing your broker more money. That's very, very dangerous. Number 37, only trade the most liquid penny stocks. I did not know this, okay, in the beginning. And I literally lost over $500,000 when I was running my hedge fund. And I destroyed all my credibility with that one loss. Even though it wasn't a typical trade for me, you know, I did not have my shit together. I did not have my rules down pat like I do now. So I deserve that. But if you stick with liquid penny stocks, there's no buts. I get messages from you guys like, I know you only focus on liquid stocks, but this stock is trading 200 shares a day, but they have an amazing new technology. I don't care. Every penny stock in the world claims to have an amazing new technology and product. They're all full of shit. And if you think that way and you're, you know, guilty until proven innocent kind of mentality with these stocks, you're better off. Number 38, trade these penny stocks near the market open and the close. The first and the last hour of the trading day is where most of the volatility happens. You do not have to sit there, you know, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern every single day, like some people do with like 10 or 20 monitors. Even if you do make money that way, you're a fucking slave. And I don't want to teach any of you guys to be slaves to the market. For me, the market is all about, you know, freeing yourself and understanding that you can trade from anywhere in the world. And obviously, I love to travel. If you focus on the first and last hour of the day, I think you'll be really okay. Number 39, dream big, but have patience. You know, this takes so much hard work and time. And many of you guys just don't have the proper perspective. You know, you're like, oh, Tim, just give me a hot pick and I'll study later. You need to prove yourself that, you know, your strategy is real. First of all, I don't have to prove anything to anybody but myself. And if I ain't done that by now, it ain't gonna never happen. It's from a little movie called Rudy, which you should see because it's so inspirational. But you need to have the proper perspective. I don't know with 100% certainty on any stock if this is going to be an amazing trade. I can't just be like, oh, okay, let me just help you cheat the process and just give you 100% surefire winner. No, you cannot cheat the process. You cannot cheat the hard work. You cannot cheat how long it takes. I'm sorry. There is no easy way to do this. The good news is it's far easier now than it was when I first started, because I had to learn everything through trial and error. And I had no idea what the rules were. I had no idea what the lessons were. I had to judge based on how I did. And some of those lessons that I now teach very quickly to you guys, I had to learn the hard way. And they cost me hundreds of thousands of dollars. So even though it's not easy, even though you are going to have to take a lot of time, be grateful that we are able now to pass these lessons down to you so that you don't have to just experiment in the market. I know many people who are like, Tim, I don't want to study with you. I don't like your attitude or your Jewish nose. I don't know. I've heard all kinds of excuses, literally a lot of anti-Semitic people. And I'm not forcing you to learn. If you don't want to learn from me, you will learn from the market. And the market is infinitely more expensive and confusing, and it'll take you a lot more time. So either way, you have to learn how it works, or you can just quit like some people do. But if you want to stick with this and you want to improve your education and you do want to make a few million dollars, I have a way of cutting down your learning curve. And that's what these lessons are all about. This is why we share all these lessons. Number 40, notice how many times I use the words Tim Gattoni in this post. I didn't count, but there's probably a lot of them. There's another Trading Challenge student, and his name is Tim Bowen. You do not need to be named Tim to be successful. Although if your name is Tim, I have to believe that your odds are a little better than most. I'm just totally kidding. It's really weird that my first two millionaire students are both, you know, young males from the Midwestern United States, but literally anybody in the world with an internet connection, it doesn't matter if you're a guy or a girl, if you're in America, Europe, Asia, South America, you can do this from anywhere. Although I would say it's difficult from Asia, as I've been, you know, trading successfully the past few weeks, but it's tough, you know, trading in the middle of the night. And Europe, frankly, for me, trading U.S. stocks is a dream, because the stock U.S. stock market is open from like 3 p.m. to 10 p.m., which I think is perfect for me. But, you know, some of you guys do like to wake up early. Some of you have different, you know, priorities and different schedules. But it's very important that you understand that this can be literally anybody. I don't know who my next millionaire student is going to be. We have several Trading Challenge students now up $600,000, $700,000, $800,000 in profits. They're well on their way. But it's not something that depends on who you are. It depends on your dedication level. I can guarantee you that my next millionaire will not be somebody who's like, oh, I don't want to study. I just want hot stock picks. I guarantee that my next millionaire will not be somebody who's like, screw all your rules, Tim. I'm going to bet it all and use leverage on this illiquid penny stock that claims to have a revolutionary product. I guarantee you that will not be my next millionaire. Millionaire students and, you know, $600,000, $700,000, $800,000 type profit students all have one thing in common, and they are notoriously, hugely, obsessively dedicated to studying and refining. Mark Crook has watched all my video lessons 3 times. Stephen Dux, you know, watches so many video lessons that he actually studies while he's on the toilet. And he admitted that to me once. And now he regrets admitting it to me because I bring it up all the time. And everyone likes to share pictures of toilets and they tag Stephen on Twitter. And it's kind of funny. You know, Tim Gattoni has so many spreadsheets tracking every single pattern. Michael Good, same kind of thing, where he's tracking different patterns, different strategies, and understanding that no one strategy is going to make you a millionaire, that different strategies work at different times. You know, sometimes the billionaire plays were hot, Ebola plays were hot, marijuana stocks go off and on being hot, police equipment stocks, low float stocks, oil stocks, gold stocks, Homeland Security. There's so many different sectors, earnings winners, shipping stocks, you know, stuff goes in and out of favor. And you have to be ready to adapt with the market. You can't just say, oh, marijuana stocks are the future. I'm just going to hold these forever. We know how that ended. And, you know, there was a whole, was it Men's Journal article where I was saying that, you know, all these patterns on marijuana stocks resemble pump and dump patterns and that they were all going to crash. This was back in 2014. And they did. And a lot of marijuana pothead lovers, you know, got crushed and they lost 50, 75, 99% of their money. So you cannot marry any stock too long. Trading is about adapting. And it doesn't matter if you go long, if you go short, you find what suits your personality, but you have to be dedicated, okay? If you're gonna be my next millionaire student, if you're gonna have a headline like this where 40 lessons from whatever your name is, you know, passing 4 million in profits, if you want this to be you, it is about dedication and studying the past and studying the present and being very meticulous. I know that you don't want to do all this work. And I know many of you guys have jobs and school and you're like, Tim, I want to do this, but I don't have time. Study at night, study on weekends. You have so much more time in life than you realize if you start to think about this in the proper way and you start to have the right priorities. And you prioritize education. If your friends call you up on a Friday night and you say, hey, we got bottles at the club, let's go out. And you say, no, I am home studying for, you know, 2 or 3 hours tonight before I go to bed early. And I'm going to wake up early. I'm going to study another 2 or 3 hours on a Saturday morning when you guys are probably still out or hungover as shit. You know, turning down Netflix and not playing video games that, frankly, just will never change your life. Education. Whether, you know, you're in Cambodia with these kids and they have, you know, literally no other choice. Or if, you know, let's say you're in a first world country like Tim Grittani and many of my top students, education is what changes lives. Building your skills, building your knowledge account before you focus on building your monetary account. And yes, I'm working on extra hours for the Trader Checklist Guide. I'm sorry it's taking me so long. I have an extra 5 hours so far. I still have to do another 5 hours. I'm going to talk a lot about building the knowledge account and how to do that. But you need the proper mindset. I know many of you guys already have the proper mindset and you're like, Tim, shut up. Don't talk about mindset anymore. I'm sick of hearing about it. I can never mention mindset and perspective enough and inspiration needed for studying because I've seen what it takes to create millionaires. And I know exactly what kind of psychology you need that will increase your odds of success. And nobody ever looks back at their education at the end of their lives and says, you know what? I really regret studying too much. Nobody has ever said those words, okay? On your deathbed, many years, many decades, many centuries, ideally with modern medicine from now, nobody will ever say, I really regret spending so much time studying, okay? You can have a lot of regrets. I regret, you know, too much drinking, too much doing nothing with my life, but you will never say, I regret studying too much. And that's why I make these videos, and that's why I'm so proud of Tim Grittani, because he studied his ass off. And if you actually look at the per hour basis of what my millionaire students and I, you know, make, it's probably not even that good. I'll tell you the truth, okay? But we don't look at it that way because we are obsessed with success. We are obsessed with, you know, figuring out what really works. And 5, 10, 20 years from now, guess what? Then our money is much bigger than the per hour basis of somebody who's in a 9-to-5 job because that's not scalable. That's the number one lesson here. This is all about scalability. The same kinds of trades that Tim Grittani took when he had just a few thousand dollars to his name are the same exact trades he's taking now, just with bigger positions. So while many of you guys with small accounts, you're studying hard and you're like, oh my God, I put in 30 hours and I only made, you know, like $60. What is that? $2 an hour? That kind of education will make you much more money 3, 4, 5, 10 years out. You just need to have the proper perspective and time horizon. So when Tim Grittani passes 4 million in 5 years, or several of my 6-figure students pass, you know, 7 figures in a few years, you start to understand scalability. Now understand there's limits to scalability with penny stocks. Like $4 million in 5 years is near best case scenario. I know there are niches out there in finance where you know, traders can make $4 million in a day using ridiculous leverage and, you know, usually dealing with inside information or getting extremely lucky. So this is a very small niche, but at the same time, because it's such a small niche, that is the gift and the curse. Because you can, quote, only make, you know, $4 million in 5 years, all the smartest people, all the richest hedge funds, they ignore these chart patterns, they ignore these plays. That's why you guys, average retail traders, have such a good chance of winning if you take advantage of these patterns. I cannot stress to you enough that you do not want to compete in a playing field where you have no edge. I would never want you guys to trade Forex. In options, I know that some of you guys are partaking in it. You're like, Jim, I can make so much money so quickly with options. There's no way to cut losses quickly. The liquidity isn't there. And we had an options newsletter once upon a time on Profitly where several people were like, oh my God, Tim, this is great. I'm up $70,000 in a few days. And then a few days later, they say, Tim, I have to cancel my subscription. I was like, what are you talking about? You just made $70,000 in a few days. They lost it all and more and $200,000. Because when you start playing with bigger numbers and these niches where you can't control your losses and you're competing against far richer, far wealthier, far, you know, better trained professionals, your odds of success go down. And Tim Grittani, myself, Michael Good, Stephen Ducks, Mark Crook, and all my top students, these are just a few examples, we have learned that, you know, making a few thousand dollars here or there or taking bigger positions like Tim Grittani does, you know, or Stephen Ducks is a very aggressive trader too. And, you know, that's why he made nearly $100,000 last week. This is damn good money for the work, and we have odds on our side. You know, perhaps the best lesson I can give you right here with Tim Grittani's trades, he's winning, look at this, 69% of the time. Let me just change this real quick. I'm going to change this to myself in my charts. I'm winning 74% of the time. Let's see, Ducks. He's winning 74.38% of the time. This is crazy. We don't all trade the same, okay? We trade in different patterns. We trade different stocks. But by and large, our winning percentage is 60, 65, 70, 75% of the time. Let's see what Michael Good is. And our gains are bigger than our losses. Michael Good has, quote, only made $2 million, and he's winning only 63% of the time. And look at his average gain, $600. He trades a lot more. And then Mark Crook, let's see what he's done. He's winning 55% of the time, okay? So it's not perfect. We're not winning 100% of the time, but we are winning more than we lose, and our dollar gains are bigger than our dollar losses. So that is how it adds up to, you know, millions of dollars. And look at this. Mark Crook, look at his profit chart. Very nice and gradual. Michael Good, very nice and gradual. Stephen Ducks, very nice and gradual. Mine, very nice and gradual. And, you know, Tim Grittani, he, out of all of us, he has the you know, choppiest chart because, again, he's had the most success, but he also trades the most aggressively. So what you can take away from this, sure, trade aggressively like Tim Grittani if you are prepared, if you understand the potential consequences of trading so aggressively. Or cut losses quickly like me and trade like a freaking coward and you won't be, you know, as profitable. I'm up like, what, $60,000 or $70,000 this year. Granted, I'm trading from the other side of the world and I still have to do better, you know, trading my small account. But at the same time, I have what works for me and my personality. And I'm very proud to teach you how to trade cowardly. Tim Grittani can help teach you to trade more aggressively. There's no one right formula to making millions of dollars. And I encourage you to learn from all successful traders. Successful traders being those of us who show every trade. I would not dare give a damn or trust any trader who only shows a few screenshots because, of course, they're only going to show their best trades. They're not going to show their losses, and that's very dangerous. A lot of people are following people who, you know, frankly, have big-ass losses, and they just hide them because they want to be social media heroes, and their ego can't take the fact when they have losses. So Tim Grittani, props to him. Congratulations on 4 million. Again, go to timothysykes.com, read this whole blog post, and leave a comment below thanking Tim Grittani, congratulating him, just showing him the power of our community and how much we appreciate, you know, his transparency and sharing his journey with us. Thank you, guys. I'll see you in the chat room tomorrow. We got a busy week, it looks like, so come early and be prepared. Thank you.
My name is Tim Sykes, and I teach people to trade stocks. I am a self-made multimillionaire.
So this is the ideal trade that I'm going to talk about. I want you guys to understand every single aspect of this trade.